Hi guys, you might be wondering what is origami doing along with evolution. Origami is the art of paper folding, and I just made this nice cute little airplane. What origami does is you start with a single piece of paper, you fold it, and you based on how you fold it, you can create very nice 3D shapes. And what does it have to do with biology? I'm a development biology studying evolution. So if you look at all the different types of origami that you do, then based on the principles, you can create different 3D structures. And now in development, when embryogenesis happens or an organism develops, you make organs, you make hands, you make feet, you fold the tissues differently. So a tissue, which is a collection of cells, it is like a 2D sheet. And you're folding this tissue sheet to make your organs and your organ systems. And you can make all these different animals using similar types of principle or different types of principles. So that is origami and development. And now what does this have to do with evolution? So all of the developmental study, so development is a very old principle, but molecular, cellular, and genetic analysis are more or less the last 30 to 50 years. So in all of these different analyses, primarily the famous five model organisms have been used: fly, fish, frog, mouse, chick to some extent. And what we find out through studying these organisms is mechanisms, a mechanism for making a hand, let's say. But the question is this mechanism reused during the development of that organism, or is it a unique mechanism? Secondly, now the evolutionary layer comes into play. I discovered a mechanism in fly. Is that mechanism specific to the flies, or is it used anywhere else by any other organism? The way we make our hands, or the way we make our facial features, do the insects also use some similar mechanism? And that is what I'm interested in studying, the evolution of developmental mechanism. And for that, I'm studying a beetle. Now here you have to believe me, it's a pain to start studying a new model system, and especially trying to do genetics and imaging in a completely new model system. And since I'm doing it, I decided to do it with the very advanced imaging technique called as light sheet microscopy, which is abbreviated as PIM here. So what you're seeing here are five different views. It's a 3D imaging. I take my sample, put it in a microscope, and rotate it. And in this case, I can take five different views for the same embryo. Then I put it through some softwares. It's an open access software called as Fiji. And I combine these different views together. And what happens after combining is something like this. This is only one developmental stage, and you can see the entire embryo, all the different dorsoventral sides, all the different poles of the embryo, which you will be seeing as this image rotates. So this is very fancy, and I can get really high resolution 3D, 4D data. I can do 10 to 12 hours of imaging using that and get a lot of information. What's the problem there? The problem is this type of a microscopy generates terabytes of data, and you can't really look at 3D data. So the best way I personally feel is to make maps. So this is a conventional way, and what you see as the seal there is a cylinder. And when you roll out a cylinder on a clay, you see the projection of that. So very similar to the Earth's map projections or cartographic projections, I have a projection for my embryo of interest on the right. And as you see now, this movie progresses. This is one part, which is the below part here, called as ventral, and this is the dorsal part or the upper part there. And I can start comparing all the different tissues in one plane. I can count how many nuclei are there. I can count what is the speed of this closure. And I can start answering very specific questions. How do you close this window? This is a very classic tissue process. You make multiple folds, and now you want to bring those folds together. How do you do that? Is the mechanism similar to other insects? Is this a completely new mechanism? And just as a snippet for that, I will show you the next movie, which is this. And here I'm trying to study a cable. This cable pulls and closes the tissue together. And for non-biologists, there are some proteins that we know are already involved in this. So now, as you see, in my case, I see there is a cable here. The white highlights that cable, and I'm plotting here the overall evolution during the development of this organism. The interesting conclusion, cables exist in other systems also, so that's a conserved process, but a completely new shape exists in this organism. And using all of these now, using the high resolution 3D, 4D data, completely new model systems, and this type of a biological analysis, you can start understanding more relevant evolutionary questions of conservation and divergence of morphogenesis. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. That was little experiment, because this is